Tonight on Evening, a battle of Super Bowl proportions. Behind the scenes of Seahawks versus Monsters. Rough, tough lineman Germain Ifedi shares his favorite poem.
Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun, or fester like a sore and then run?
The stars of the new movie Sleepless tell Kim about the perils of shooting action scenes.
But I did sort of chip his tooth.
Wait, what?
And I'm Jim Dever in Atlanta, Georgia, home of this weekend's NFL Showdown, the NFC divisional playoff game between your Seattle Seahawks and the Atlanta Falcons. Now, in the past, I have ventured deep behind enemy lines to stir up trouble in Denver, in San Francisco, in Charlotte. The list goes on and on and on. And today, history will be made again right here on the streets of Atlanta. You can count on it. But first, let's head back over to Seattle, where Michael King is holding down the fort. Hey, Michael.
Holding down the fort here in Seattle, Jim. And the key to Saturday's game in Atlanta is going to be the offensive line. Can the Hawks run the ball like they did against the Lions? And one of the keys to the offensive line is number 76, Germain Ifedi. Let's get to know the rookie a little bit better on tonight's Hangin' with the Hawks. Now, when you're a first-round draft pick, get to do cool things like throw out the first pitch at a Mariner game. I asked Germain if he threw a strike.
You know, it probably would have been close. You know, I maybe would have got a swing.
Right, sure.
I wouldn't say it would have been a called strike, though. Like,
yeah. Well, that's impressive, though, since you didn't play baseball.
Never thrown a baseball before.
Okay, so you're listed on the roster at 6'5", 325. Are those numbers accurate?
Give me an inch and 10 pounds.
So you think you're 6'6"?
Yes.
Okay. They mismeasure you. Well, let's see if I think I might be a little bit taller than you. Let's see.
What do you think? It might be a little bit
more. Actually, I think you are twice me. You're 6'5 at least.
Yeah, at least.
One thing I want to ask about offensive linemen, I see you guys before a play, you're down in your stance and you're pointing. The center often does that. What's going on there?
He's just pointing out like who the guy we're responsible for, who the running back's responsible for, who we're going to. Things like that, you know, it's nothing too like complicated. He's just kind of pointing out.
So it's just, got that guy?
Is
that
We have that guy. Like, we're right. Sliding to that guy, we're going to that guy, whatever the case may be.
I was checking out your Instagram and I found this poem. Can you read that?
Yeah.
Read that for us.
What happens to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun, or fester like a sore and then run? Does it stink like rotten meat, or crust and sugar over like a syrupy sweet? Maybe it just sags like a heavy load. Or does it explode? A Dream Deferred by Langston Hughes.
Why'd you put that on your Instagram? That's cool.
I don't know. I mean, it just really used to inspire me. Like, it's really one of those poems that you can just read it and you just kind of like think like, go for it.
We like to play this game called What the Heck is Going On Here? So what the heck is going on there?
So, you know, Texas A&M is a tradition-rich school. So our mascot is this dog, his name Reveille. And if they come to your class and the dog barks, the class is dismissed early, as tradition. But the dog is super well trained and never.
Oh, too bad.
I think it's like I've heard a couple instances of it barking, but it's super duper rare because super well trained.
So you took that picture in class?
Yeah, and obviously I shouldn't have been in class because no one else is there. But,
that's excellent. Yeah. I also noticed I looked at some of your old Texas A&M pictures. You were wearing number 74 there, and now you wear 76 for the Hawks.
Yeah.
Why'd you change?
You know, I always wore 76 when I first started playing middle school, high school. You know, I got to Texas A&M, one of our starting linemen, he was a junior, he was wearing 76. So I was like, oh, you know, let me switch it up, go to 74. You know, I got comfortable with it, but, you know, 76 was where, you know, home was. So I got to league and I got an opportunity to get on a team that had a number available. I jumped at the opportunity.
Went back to 76. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. Germain, good to meet you.
Yes, sir.
Thanks a million. Yeah. Good luck out there.
Thank you.
Great to meet that guy. Watch for Germain's number 76 tomorrow in Atlanta, and Atlanta better watch out for 12th man, Jim Dever.
Thanks, Michael. You enjoy dressing up in crazy costumes and causing mischief, right?
Sometimes.
Well, how do you like this idea? I transform into 12th man, the Seahawks superhero, and I perform good deeds here on the streets of Atlanta for Falcons fans.
Oh, I love that idea.
Yeah, I thought you'd like that. Check it out.
I am 12th man, Seahawks superhero, bringing goodwill to the people of Atlanta.
Oh.
Do you find that interesting?
I do.
Do you find me attractive?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very good. You may pass. Can I help you? Do you need directions?
No, not at all.
Would you like a recommendation for lunch?
No, thank you.
I am a superhero.
I see a superhero.
Yes, a superhero. I will push your car through the intersection.
Thank you.
There you go. Farewell, Atlantan. I am 12th Man, Seahawks superhero. You are not wearing a helmet. That's incredibly dangerous.
He's too damn strict, man.
I'm only interested in your safety, sir.
Thank you, sir.
They're a little tight, but that's why they call them tights.
Tight. Call they a tight.
Yes. Hello, Max. Hello, Rambler. There's a hydrant on the corner you might find helpful. Are you giving them directions?
Yeah.
I have a better way. Go out Marietta. Take a right on 3rd. Make a left on 10th Street, I believe it is. You're welcome.
Okay.
Be careful, you're gonna get dizzy going 360 around me like that.
Y'all would go down. I'm a Falcon fan, baby!
Falcon is an inferior bird, but I appreciate your point of view. Does it feel like iron or steel? I have no idea what you're saying. What is your prediction for the score this weekend?
I put us about 49 to like 20.
That's true. Seahawks win. Good day. Go Hawks. Korea is a very nice country.
Oh, yeah.
I speak Korean and you? 5 other languages fluently.
You?
Yes. I don't want to do it right now, though.
Why?
I'm saving it for a performance tonight.
Okay. What kind of performance are you doing?
Korean opera. To whom are you speaking?
Not your business.
I speak 24 languages. I might be able to help you. Ask me any question you like in Chinese, okay. And I will answer it.
Okay. 今天晚上有 NBA 的比赛吗?
Yes, but only on every other Thursday.
No, wrong.
Oh.
Excuse me.
No charge, ma'am. I'm unarmed. I am unarmed.
Find this boy, guys. Take it back to Seattle.
My work here is done.
My apologies to the people of Atlanta and fans of good taste everywhere. But I will say, Tay here from Atlanta
is actually a Seahawks fan.
Here,
you know.
Use this and say, go Hawks.
Go Hawks, man. You know, Seahawks Nation.
All right, now be careful because your friends are not going to be very happy about
that. I know, we Atlanta fans.
You're Atlanta fans, I know. Well, you know, this weekend at the Georgia Dome, it's Seahawks. Hang on, I'm trying to do a TV show here. You can rest your arm there, though. This weekend at the Georgia Dome, it's Seahawks versus Falcons. But at a film festival a little bit later on in Seattle this month, it is Seahawks versus Monsters.
Know your bins and sort your refuse.
Improperly sorted garbage leads to an environmental catastrophe, which gives rise to mega mutants who can only be stopped by one team, the Seattle Seahawks. That is the perfectly plausible premise of the aptly named Seahawks versus Monsters, a short film that spread like a radioactive virus across the internet.
Like 60s-style Japanese kaiju monster movie.
Filmmakers Chris Caldwell and Zeke Earl pitched the idea to the Hawks with low expectations.
Our first thought was, there's no way we get to do this.
When the Seahawks surprisingly said yes, Chris and Zeke's team at Shep Films, along with Seattle's Electric Coffin Design Studio, sprang into action.
So we set up a whole studio set adjacent to the practice field. Put it out to the team, you're like, who wants to be in it? And we thought, you know, maybe like one or two guys would do it. And we were surprised that like a lot of people wanted to be in this.
You want more space?
They were also surprised by the players' enthusiastic performances.
They would bring a lot of their own ideas into it. When you give a football player a monster to attack, they're gonna have a lot of ideas.
There's a goofy guy in a fish costume, and there's like these like ridiculous sets. And we have like 60 seconds to explain it to them because there's so little time. And they all took it really seriously, and they got really into it.
Seahawks versus Monsters might not win an Oscar, but it's winning the hearts of fans happy to see the lighter side of their favorite team.
It makes people smile.
The Emerald City is safe once again thanks to our incredible Seattle Seahawks.
There's a screening of Seahawks versus Monsters at the Cinerama for the Science Fiction and Fantasy Short Film Festival later on this month. All the information is on a link at our website. More from Atlanta, Georgia in just a minute.
Things get real when Kim talks to the stars of the new movie Sleepless.
So the takeaway is don't tussle with Michelle Monaghan in real life. Don't do it.
Get your teeth knocked out.
And from pastries to pasta, Chef Kevin Davis shares his favorite Seattle spots in tonight's Where the Chefs Eat.
Good evening, I am David Espinosa Hall.
And I'm Amanda Grace.
Most people think working in news is all about being first to break the story, sensationalizing what's actually happening, when really, it's all about you. You allow us into your homes to share what matters most to you. And in the end, we hope we can make a difference. This is our motivation, and it drives everything we do. King 5 News on Kong. See you tonight.
Once upon a time, a microbiologist named Dr. Shiroa shared his discovery with the world. It was a unique strain of probiotic bacteria named Lactobacillus casei shirota, which he used to create Yakult in support of good health. Now millions of families from east to west help balance their digestive systems with Yakult every day. Here's to you, Dr. Shirota.
Secret life of pets.
Want a TV experience that gives you more? With the fastest in-home Wi-Fi and the most streaming content, Xfinity gives you more ways to watch more entertainment. And now to save more money, too. The Xfinity Lock and Go event. For a limited time, lock in a special rate until January 2019. Get more to stream to any screen. And now enjoy the same low rate for 2 full years. Get started with Xfinity X1 and the fastest in-home Wi-Fi and lock in your rate until 2019. Or ask how to upgrade for $400 back. Call, click, or visit an Xfinity store today.
Every week is a new box full of fresh, seasonal ingredients and step-by-step recipes so you can make dinner that's stirred, seared, topped, enticed, shared, loved, and delivered to perfectly fit your life. Get a free dinner for two on your first plated night. Visit cookplated.com.
Welcome back to Atlanta, Georgia, site of this weekend's playoff showdown between the Atlanta Falcons and your Seattle Seahawks. Behind me here, Centennial Olympic Park. It was built in 1996 for the Summer Olympic Games. Well, Michael King is standing by over there in Seattle. Michael, what's up?
Oh, hi, Jim. And behind me is the home of the Seattle Seahawks, built in 2002. And look, up in the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane. No. It's Sidney Rice on top of the needle, raising the flag. This has become a really cool Blue Friday tradition around here. Sidney also showing off his fancy Seahawk necklace. But the Hawks game isn't the only thing going on this weekend.
Steve-o!
Lines out the door for shock comic Steve-O. He's performing this weekend at Tacoma Comedy Club.
It was wild. I was standing on top of a porta potty while my buddy crashed a car through it. I was trying to land on a skateboard. So it was a totally freak accident.
Ah, Steve-O, he'll be there all weekend in Tacoma. He has a Sunday night show as well, although I think that most shows are sold out. All right, let's get back to Atlanta and 12th Man.
Thanks, Michael. Yeah, it's great to get out of those 12th Man tights. Demetrius Beck here is my background extra. You'll see him walking back and forth in the background. Back, come back again. And try to look natural. There's a great movie coming out tonight. It is action-packed. It's called Sleepless. It stars Jamie Foxx and Michelle Monaghan. He plays the role of a cop who's trying to fight back after his kid has been kidnapped. Very action-packed, but there was a mishap during a fight scene. Demetrius, you went too far. Come back. There was a mishap during a fight scene that they tell Kim all about. Check it out. And cut. Nice job!
I gotta talk to you guys about the fight scenes. Is it more cathartic to punch or kick or yell profanities when making a movie like this?
Oh, that's a tough question.
Sort of both of them.
I will say, like, the physical aspect of it, you know, I trained pretty extensively for it.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't hurt him. Inevitably, I did sort of. I don't think I actually hurt him, but I did sort of chip his tooth.
Yeah. Wait, what? Seriously?
I did.
Doing a scene and somehow,
I got a little closer.
The action cue got thrown off, or I wasn't looking right, but boom, she comes down the pipe. And I could tell because all this right here is fake. You know, this is, all this is here is, you know, just the Denzels.
Oh.
So as soon as that hit, I could taste the, you know, the little chalkiness.
Yeah, I chipped it.
Yeah.
But we kept rolling.
You know, and
keep going. On top of them, thinking, okay, what's the next punch move?
With you and T.I. on the set, was there spontaneous music breaking out on set ever?
The one night that I'm bummed that I missed out on was the nightclub scene, which all I heard, I think it was on a Friday night you guys shot that, and all I heard about on Monday morning at 5 a.m. was how amazing Jamie was. There were like probably 500 people there or something, extras in the nightclub. And you got up there and you entertained everybody all night long with singing.
Time.
You have done so much in your career, from music to playing such a variety of characters. I mean, what is left at this point? Shakespeare? Like, what do you have left to do?
No, we got some stuff to do. There's so many stories out there. I don't even think we have enough time to get all these stories.
Yeah.
So there's so much. It's so true.
And I don't even know what the stories are until all of a sudden something lands in my lap. Yeah. And I go, oh my gosh, this is, wow, this perspective, or, you know, feeling the need to, like, put myself in that person's shoes. And so it's, of course I have ideas in my head, but it's being surprised by the things that you have no clue that you're, you know, that's what's lined up for you.
Right, like breaking Jamie Foxx's tooth.
Yeah, exactly. Yes.
Kim says she enjoyed talking to the actors, but the film itself is actually kind of disappointing. She said the story makes no sense whatsoever, and the violence is way over the top to the point of almost being laughable. Hey, great review. Go on out and see it. Sleepless is rated R. It is now screening. I say C. You say Hawks. C. C.
The new app catching fire with teens and 20-somethings. And a pair of smart leggings are what's trending. Plus, Chef Kevin Davis with a delicious tour of his favorite Seattle spots. Travel provided by Alaska Airlines, offering the most flights to the most destinations from the West Coast. For their lowest fares, visit alaskaair.com. Extreme. Unique.
You become instantly confused and lost and disoriented.
Take a drive down I-5 and see why Rip City is such a hip city. Evening, Monday at 7:30 on King 5.
It's time to follow every river, to explore every path, every mountain, every road, every trail. It's time for life in the aggressively sophisticated all-wheel drive 2017 Toyota Highlander. Lease one now for $349 a month. See your local Toyota dealer or visit buyatoyota.com today. Toyota, let's go places.
Hey, man.
Sorry, man, I can't make it. It's okay.
I'm sending a friend.
What's that? I hear somebody needs a fifth.
I'd make a fan's day every day.
Game night is our daughter Allie's favorite night. And knowing that her favorite General Mills Big G cereals are gluten-free, like Honey Nut Cheerios, Rice Chex, and Lucky Charms, she can enjoy it her way.
You said you wanted to feel better about your cereal. General Mills Big G cereals hear you. That's why we say yes to whole grain as our first ingredient, and no way to high fructose corn syrup. So no matter what your favorite is, you can feel good about General Mills Big G cereals.
This is the Silverado Special Edition.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice. Strength and style.
Get an average total value of $6,150 on Chevy Silverado All-Star Editions. Plus, find your tag to get an additional $1,000 on select Chevy vehicles. See your Northwest Chevy dealer.
It's Rich's year-end clearance. Tremendous once-a-year savings on all fireplaces, inserts, and stoves. Only Rich's has the nation's largest selection, 5-day installation, and 2 years no-interest financing. Hurry! Savings end soon at Rich's.
Welcome back to Evening in Atlanta. I'm Jim Dever, and this is CNN. Atlanta, of course, home to CNN, home to Coca-Cola, and home to a whooping this weekend. The Seattle Seahawks over the Atlanta Falcons by a score of 43-3. You can take that to the bank. Well, you wonder what's hot this week? Well, I'm wondering, and that's why we're going to check in with our own Keiko Sagami and Carla Marie from Power 93.3. Here's what's trending.
Yeah, hey, we're hanging out at Hot Cakes Molten Chocolate Cakery in Capitol Hill, where they specialize in the most amazing dessert.
It smells so good.
I know, like if you see what's hanging out in front of us, this is the s'mores chocolate molten cake, and it is so, so good looking.
But first we gotta talk.
I know, we can't taste
okay?
it yet.
Okay.
So first off, we're talking about the House Party app, and it is the coolest new app that's really popular with a lot of high schoolers and college kids. It's basically a video chat room.
Oh
and
boy.
So you open the app and you can think of it kind of as Snapchat. You talk to your friends.
But you see everybody.
Yeah, you see everybody and more friends can join in. So it's a great way to meet people because you don't necessarily have to be friends with those people. You just have to have a mutual friend.
So you're just talking to random people, kind of like FaceTiming with random people.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow. All right, that's cool. But this is awesome. You're gonna be obsessed. It's called Like a Glove. They're leggings that you put on. And as you can see, there's wiring in there. So you hit this little button, and it, all the information of the leggings will download to an app on your phone.
Like
and
your exact size.
Your exact size. And it tells you the best jeans for your size, the style, the brand, and the size.
Okay, lastly, Nails by Yvonne, her Instagram account is
checking.
So fabulous. It's just nail art to the max. You've seen all these artists on Pinterest and whatnot,
what?
But there's an artist here next to us in Kent.
She's right here.
Yeah, Levon Nails. If you check out her Instagram, she does nails that are like blinged out marble, icicles,
obsessed.
And like glow in the dark. Literally the coolest stuff.
Okay.
All right, now, but we gotta dig in.
Okay, we're doing it?
Yeah,
cheers.
All right, thank you, Keiko and Carla Marie. For more information about all that stuff, just go on over to our website at king5.com/evening.
Plan your next culinary adventure with picks from a top Seattle chef right after this. Extreme. Unique.
You become instantly confused and lost and disoriented.
Take a drive down I-5 and see why Rip City is such a hip city. Evening, Monday at 7:30 on King 5.
It's time to follow every river, to explore every path, every mountain, every road, every trail. It's time for life in the aggressively sophisticated all-wheel drive 2017 Toyota Highlander. Lease one now for $349 a month. See your local Toyota dealer or visit buyatoyota.com today. Toyota, let's go places.
Now for everyone looking for a hot new restaurant, Lucky Eagle Casino introduces the Fire Kitchen Buffet. Complete with mouth-watering seafood and carving stations, Mexican dishes, awesome desserts, and so much more. All surrounding an amazing indoor fire pit featuring our signature altar-smoked salmon. So get fired up to play. Discover the new Fire Kitchen Buffet at Lucky Eagle Casino and Hotel, where you belong.
All right. Right there is great. Today, our deluxe wash is free.
Great.
But I think you'll find it surprisingly satisfying.
Number six?
I'm six, but that's not my car.
You sure?
Positive. This is your car.
How is this my car?
We're giving you a car today.
Are you kidding?
Boss says this one's yours.
Oh, yeah.
I'd make a few people's day every day.
Thanks for using Like New.
King 5, U.S. Bank, and you have made the 2016 Home Team Harvest another big success. Thank you for being such a huge part of it.
More people than ever are choosing Nissan, making us North America's fastest growing auto brand in 2016. Take on 2017 and get the safety you'd expect, the fuel efficiency you need, and America's best truck warranty. Get to Nissan's Take On 2017 event. for 0% financing for up to 72 months on 11 models, or save up to $10,000 on select models.
Tonight, Lester Holt joins the president for his last trip on Air Force One. Rare access and a candid conversation in Chicago.
Sounds like you'd like a do-over.
Well, no.
The man behind the office, only on NBC.
Okay, let's try again. Hi, I'm Felicity Jones, and it is great to be here hosting Saturday Night Live. What do you think? Do you think I'm ready? Thanks, guys. You're a real bunch of troopers.
Cheesy.
Maybe we lose that one.
Welcome back to Evening from Hotlanta. Go Hawks. You know, finding the perfect place to eat can be hit or miss. We're going to help make it more of a hit for you. We've asked popular local chefs to tell us the places that just can't fail. Here's Michael King with tonight's Where the Chefs Eat.
When Kevin Davis moved to Seattle 19 years ago, he was just another chef in a new city. Now, he's a restaurateur. Kevin and his wife Teresa own Steelhead Diner in Pike Place Market, Blue Acres Seafood on 7th and Olive, and their newest place in Belltown, an Italian wood-fired kitchen called Orfeo. When Kevin isn't cooking in one of his kitchens, he likes to check out what other chefs are creating in theirs. Kevin's first stop has been a hit since they opened their doors.
Here we are at the Bakery Nouveau on Capitol Hill. This actually is the second location. They started in West Seattle.
While they offer up more than just baked goods, Kevin can't resist the pan au chocolat.
This is what makes it so beautiful. You see how crisp that is and crunchy? That's where all the art is. It's perfect.
Just down the street, another place making things practically perfect.
Okay, so here we are on Capitol Hill at Cucina Spinace, which is one of my favorite restaurants in Seattle. Here we'll find some of the best examples of handmade pasta in Seattle, if not America.
Spinace has been making pasta by hand since they opened in 2008. One of the most difficult to make is also one of Kevin's favorites to eat, the tagliarini.
A perfectly cooked tagliarini. It's hard to tell where the butter ends and the pasta begins. It just melts away in your mouth. Perfect.
Kevin's final stop finds him with an old friend in Fremont at Rock Creek Seafood and Spirits.
The chef has always had a very deft hand with seafood. He's very passionate about his cuisine. How you doing, Eric? So he opened up his own restaurant, Rock Creek, and he's doing a great job. I want to have my favorite dish, which is the black cod provençale. Sauteed black cod on the outside, beautiful crust, crispy onions, and a nice little lime finish in the sauce. Beautiful.
All right, thanks Kevin for letting us tag along. An all new Grimm is up next. Have a great weekend, and
Atlanta, prepare to be defeated.
Go Hawks.